Hello, my friends. Welcome to Breakfast with Sergio. In today's episode, I'm going to share with you the story of how I sold my first artwork. Well, hello, my friends. Welcome to Breakfast with Sergio. Today, in my plate, welcome to my table, I have a delicious chile relleno, which has really awesome vegetables and cheese in the inside. They are homemade by yours truly. And I've been learning how to do chile relleno, so I'm working on it, and it looks and also smells really, really good. Well, my friend, today I want to talk to you about, you know, how did I sell my first artwork? And this was a question that was sent to me through Instagram by Farah Art Creations on Instagram, and she sent me a question. She said, Sergio, how did you, can you share on Breakfast with Sergio, how did you sell your first artwork? How much did you sell it for? And that is a great question. Thank you so much, Farah Art Creations for sending the question to me through Instagram. Well, the answer to that question is very simple. It actually, I do remember the first time I sold a work of art to somebody that I didn't know, right? To somebody outside of my family and friends and things like that. And I was a student at the School of the Art Institute in Chicago. This was the year around 1993, I think, if I remember correctly, 1992, 93 or so. And the school, it was actually around this time of the year, the school had a holiday art sale, which invited students to get a little corner in this big room, the School of the Art Institute of Chicago, behind the museum. And, you know, you could bring small artwork and put it out there, and they advertised it as a holiday art sale by students of the School of the Art Institute. So I did that, right? I was new at the school, and I thought, well, this is a great opportunity to, you know, put something out for sale. And I actually went and I put, you know, my table. And the first thing that I sold was a small picture, a small painting about 8 by 10 inches. I think I had it priced at around $300, $400, something really small. And I don't remember the exact amount, but it was somewhere around there. For sure it was under $500. And it was nicely framed. It was an oil painting of a crucifixion. And it was actually purchased by a priest. A priest went to the holiday sale, saw the work, purchased it, we exchanged information. And then actually what I came to find out years later is that he donated the piece, the artwork, to the collection of the Benedictine University here in the outskirts of Chicago. And the artwork is still there as part of their permanent collection, which I was very pleasantly surprised when he invited me, you know, years later. We stayed in touch for many years. And Father Reverend Michael Komisak, which now has passed away, but he left behind a huge legacy of artwork that he purchased over the years and donated to the collection of Benedictine University. And he has a fabulous collection of art. And you know, it was because through him that he purchased this small work during the holiday season through an art holiday sale from the School of the Art of Chicago, that my work got into that collection. And you know, eventually he purchased a second one over the years. And that was my very first art sale, during a holiday art sale. So you can see, my friends, how, you know, I still today often think about the holidays as a great season in which, you know, you can promote your work in a small scale, small sizes, because that creates like a perfect gift or a perfect offer that you can offer during the holidays. But, you know, that was the answer. That's the answer to that question. And, you know, also, you know, the more I think about that, you just never know, right? You just never know when somebody purchases one of your pieces, whether it's a large work or even it's a small thing, something maybe that might seem insignificant to you, but you never know who that person is or what that work may end up being at. You know, I had no idea that, you know, that work had, you know, eventually would go to a permanent collection from a university here in the area. So it's great, you know, it's great. It's just a great story, and I'm glad that you asked. So again, you know, the kind of like the thing to learn from that is that you just never know where the artwork is going to be at. And always, you know, create opportunities for people to buy, create opportunities for people to engage with you and the things that you are doing, And that always, you know, is something that you can do for the long run of your art career. And actually, I did that again a second time. I did the same thing. And the second time, I sold, again, I was a student, I sold two pieces to a doctor in Paris. So a doctor who was in Chicago for a visit to Chicago, purchased two of my paintings. One was a figurative study, figurative painting study, purchased that one. And another one, which was a little bit more abstract. They were all school assignments, and he purchased it. And actually, we stayed in touch over the years. And, you know, I think last time I heard from him was about 5 years ago or so, that he still had those pieces in his home in Paris. So, again, you just never know when the work may end up. And sometimes you know, and sometimes you don't know. Sometimes, you know, as it has happened in my case, a lot of my early works, I have no idea where they ended up. I have no clue. And of course, back then it was before social media, before I was even organized with business cards and stuff like that. So a lot of contacts that people gave me over the years, I've lost them, you know, put them in a box and the box disappeared. Or, you know, I just put them in my back pocket and then would lose them. Again, I was much younger. In my younger years, wasn't as organized and as up to the business of art as I am now, right? Everything that I'm teaching you now in business. But if, as we said here, I wish I had known them back then I would have followed those, you know, that kind of advice myself as well as an artist. But again, it all kind of points to the same thing, right? You just never know where you are, where it's going to be. So always create opportunities for people. And always, whenever somebody makes a purchase of one of your artworks, always make it the best and the most meaningful interaction that you can, so that they remember you, so that they are willing to go back again as well. So thanks again for watching this episode, my friends. Today's episode was sponsored by the Art Next Level Academy, where we help artists just like you take their art career to the next level. Just message me if you would like some help in your art career. Have a great day. Goodbye.